Us babies seem to put everything into our mouth. It's all part of the adventure of learning. It seems that if we can reach it, we will eat it. The dirty shoe, the eaten homework, the slobbery sleeve, you've seen it all.
Keeping stuff out of your baby's mouth can certainly be a challenge, but it is an important task. Choking is a serious and common problem, especially among infants under the age of one, but still significant all the way up until age five. To reduce your baby's chance of choking, wait until your baby is around 6 months old before introducing any solid foods to his meals. The American Academy of Pediatrics recommends exclusive breastfeeding for about the first 6 months of a baby's life, followed by breastfeeding in combination with the introduction of complementary foods until at least 12 months of age.
When you do introduce solids, start with small amounts of pureed, semi-liquidy food. After your baby becomes comfortable with this consistency, you can gradually thicken the food by adding less liquid. In the next stage, give your baby mashed food that is a little bit thicker. Eventually, as your baby's teeth and molars grow in, you can introduce finger foods. The finger foods should be soft and cut down to small, pea-sized pieces. Avoid cutting food into disc or circular shapes. Chokeable foods such as hard candy, nuts, gum, marshmallows, peanut butter, grapes, diced apples, raw carrots, popcorn, and hot dogs should not be given to infants or toddlers. Children should sit and be supervised by an adult while eating. Many choking incidents have occurred when an older child gives a baby a dangerous toy or food.
Away from mealtime, keep all small items off of the floor, including marbles, safety pins, coins, pen and marker caps, uninflated balloons, etc. These items are potentially dangerous and can easily become a choking hazard for your little one. Be vigilant and aware of what your child puts in their mouth. Check toys for loose parts. Is Teddy's eye loose? Did Barbie lose a shoe? Crawl around your home and take a look at your environment from your child's perspective.
You can check to see if small objects are a potential choking hazard by using a choke test cylinder. A simple tester can be made at home with a toilet paper tube, or you can purchase one online. If an item can fit entirely into the cylinder, keep it out of reach of your child. Only allow your child to play with age-appropriate and non-recalled toys. Information on safe toy products, as well as other products that your child uses routinely, can be found at the Consumer Product Safety Commission website.
The purpose of this video is to teach only the very most basic information on choking prevention and is not intended to be your only source of information. Please educate yourself further by taking a CPR and first aid class. CPR is a critical skill for everyone, but especially important for parents and caregivers of young children. Different techniques are used for different age groups, and performing the techniques improperly can be harmful to your child.
If your baby's airway becomes blocked from a reason other than choking, such as allergies, swelling, or croup, call 911 and perform infant CPR immediately. However, if you determine that your baby is choking on an object, allow her to cough if she is able to. Coughing is the best way to expel an object. If she cannot cough or cry, her airway is likely to be completely blocked. Act quickly to remove the item by performing the following steps for babies under 1 year of age.
First, have someone call 911, or if you are alone, perform the following steps for 2 minutes before calling 911.
Next, place your baby face down on your forearm, keeping her head lower than her body.
Use your forearm, resting upwards, on your thigh to support your baby's head. Keep your baby's neck straight and do not cover her mouth. Use your thumb and fingers to hold her jaw.
Now, with the heel of your hand, give up to 5 firm back slaps between her shoulder blades.
If the item does not come out, turn your baby face up, continuing to support her head and keeping her head lower than her chest.
Next, find your baby's chest bone slightly below the nipple line, and with 2 or 3 fingers, quickly and smoothly thrust downward 5 times. Push straight down on her chest, about 1.5 inches deep.
Continue giving 5 back slaps, alternating with 5 chest thrusts, until the item becomes dislodged or your baby begins to cough or cry.
After the item has been removed, there may be soft tissue damage or swelling in the throat, which is a life-threatening emergency. It is critically important to have your child evaluated by paramedics, an emergency facility, or your pediatrician right away.
If the item does not come out, or if your baby becomes unconscious, you will need to perform CPR until medical assistance arrives. Learn the proper techniques for CPR by taking a certified course.
Now, if you can just handle all of the other things that come my way, I will be on my way to growing up before you know it. So enjoy me while I'm little, because sometimes the littlest things can change your life in a big way. And sometimes the littlest moments can be precious treasures forever.